The world has just hit another unwelcome milestone, recording 15 million cases of coronavirus, which has taken the lives of more than 600,000. Many countries are racing to come up with vaccines and therapeutic treatments. As some have figured out how to slow the spread of COVID-19 and flatten their curves, it's a completely different case here in the U.S. as it inches closer to 4 million cases, with more than 142,000 American deaths. Even with alarming numbers, there's been political divide on how to deal with the virus and how to live in the new normal. Meanwhile, as President Donald Trump tries to downplay criticisms of how he's handled the pandemic, he finally resumed his daily coronavirus press briefings after a nearly three-month absence. But when in the past he was flanked by top infectious disease experts, including Dr. Anthony Fauci, this time he was all alone. Not a single health official by his side. Not even his vice president, who leads the White House Coronavirus Task Force. In a rare shift from his usual rhetoric, that massive amounts of testing is what's causing the spikes in COVID-19 cases, the president admitted the gravity of the problem.
It will probably, unfortunately, get worse before it gets better.
Reading from a prepared speech, Trump finally encouraged Americans to wear masks, as well as avoid bars and mass gatherings.
Asking Americans to use masks, socially distance, and employ vigorous hygiene, wash your hands every chance you get while sheltering high-risk populations. We are imploring young Americans to avoid packed bars and other crowded indoor gatherings, be safe and be smart.
It's a deviation from Trump's recent actions, specifically in his campaign rallies in Oklahoma, Arizona, and in Mount Rushmore, where wearing masks and social distancing were not imposed.
Certainly social distancing, that's common sense. 6 feet to me is common sense.
Meanwhile, Pence tried to defend the administration's response to the pandemic, but made it clear the big surges in the Sun Belt states are of grave concern.
All across the Sun Belt is serious, and it's the reason why we've surged resources here.
Amid criticisms that the government reopened economies too soon and too fast, Pence said those decisions were made based on the best available evidence and information at that time. Nonetheless, he vowed to continue to work with all governors as they address the surges in cases. Pence added, though, that massive shutdowns may not always be necessary. For his part, Trump reiterated that vaccines are his top priority, claiming that a couple of candidates are getting close to entering the final stages of clinical trials. He also pledged to Americans that his goal is not merely to manage the pandemic, but to end it. DJ Manotok, ABS-CBN News.